Hello there, ladies and gents. This is Connor, and this, of course, is Applaud the Mod, the series that takes a look at a variety of different modifications for the PC gaming platform. So what we're looking at today is a modification for Total War Rome 2 Emperor Edition, and it's for the story DLC, I suppose you could call it, mini campaign, Hannibal at the Gates, and it is Spartacus Rises, sat around the Servile Revolts in Rome, and far, far beyond, it would seem. So here we go. Let's take a look at the factions and the contenders. So we have the Sertorian Rebels, the Berber Kingdoms, the Massilia, Rome, the Servile Rebellion, of course, with Isle Spartacus at the head, the Lusitani, the Avaraci, and the Kingdom of Numidia in Northern Africa there. So we have a pretty damn full roster, but it is set around the Servile Revolt, so you know what, I'm not going to read all that. If you don't know what the Servile Revolt was, it is where all the slaves of the Roman Empire rise up under the gladiator Spartacus and his Gaulish friend Crixus and Gannicus, another lieutenant in their forces. And they pretty much just tore Rome apart. Ripped it apart. But this is not based on that television show Spartacus, which is a pretty damn awesome show, I have to admit. Watched it a couple of times over all the seasons. But let's get into this. You know what? It's the Spartacus Rises modification. So we have the players of the Servile Rebellion. So hard there. I usually play my campaigns on harder, even higher difficulties. Playing Total War for a pretty long time, and I still get my ass kicked every single game, but I like to feel like, you know, I'm doing pretty damn well. So let's get in here. Oh, here we go. Before I even do that there, here are the modders themselves, shown here in glorious legionary battle armor. Pac-Man, Dresden, Grudge, and Idrius. Let's get this shit on. Have to say that the loading screen art, the splash screens, are freaking awesome. Now, I am using another modification that changes the soundtrack, because I believe, and this is my opinion, of course, that the soundtrack for Rome 2 is beyond horrible. It is really, really bad. Rome 1 has one of the best soundtracks of any strategy game I've ever played. I mean, there's just one orchestral piece that goes dun 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 dun. It's just epic. And unfortunately, they have not gotten the composer to do any other Total Wars since, I could be wrong, Medieval 2 Total War. Yeah. But hopefully, with Warhammer Total War. Oh, I can't get used to saying Total War Warhammer. It's just back to front, but it doesn't sound right. I mean, they've released the majority of their games with Warhammer, or not Warhammer, with the actual age it's set around, set back as the main title. So here we go. Now, the Servile Rebellion troops, the slaves here, whenever you recruit men, they're free. They are slaves after all, unless you're going to like hire somebody outside slaves, which is nice. I mean, you can see I'm really into the red there, almost 3,000 denarii into the red, but that doesn't matter. Alright, so I have two armies here to start with. I have Crixus, our Gaulish general, good friend, but also friendly rival to Spartacus. Not really sure if that's really how they really were, but that's how the show portrayed them, which is, I just said, wasn't even based on this. Right, here we go. Spartacus, our main man. The units we've got here, there are quite a variety of them, but you have got a large, large map to, you know, conquer and conquest. It's pretty damn epic. So what I'm going to do actually is join both armies up and go take, where shall we go? You know what? Do you want to go straight for Rome? That might be a bit of a stretch, people. Right, let's see. So we have Capua. Upgrade the irrigation there. I'm not really sure it matters. I mean, food might matter. I haven't really... Yeah, I mean, unit replenishment is pretty damn important in the Total War games. Getting your troops back up to full strength. Let's upgrade the war preparation there in the research tree. We could use a few more units, couldn't we? So what have we got? Servile recruits, which are just pretty much gladiator recruits. We've got the Servel veterans, which are, you know, they've been in many battles at this point, so they've just scavenged any Roman legionary armor. Servile swordsmen, of course, and there's Spartacus himself. I believe he is on foot. We also have some Servile horsemen and herdsmen, which are just the everyday server slaves, you know, that bring food and drink. Not really trained in the art of war, but, you know, they're given javelins and they can use them to throw at their enemies. Makes them incredibly useful, actually, as like a deterrent for ranged units. Right. And what do we want? Those, see these here guys and over here, they're quite short, these servile spear units. Look at the head of these compared to the rest. Suppose the Northern European troops of the time were a lot bigger people. Big hairy Norsemen compared to the little short Italians of the time. You can even get a mod that actually changes that, but I'm not really sure of the name of it. Let's get some servile infantry. And Servile Swordsman, there we go, that'll do us. Crixus, he could use a pretty damn large force, I think. Get a couple of Servile Spearmen there. Don't know why we would even consider getting recruits at this point. They do look pretty cool, you know, with their gladiator armor and stuff, but I believe they're outclassed, yeah. Oh, actually, they're pretty damn good. I didn't even notice the stats there for the melee attack. They're pretty damn good, actually. I mean, you'd consider the fact that they're recruits, that they'd be, you know, worse than the Servile Swordsmen and stuff, but they're not. They're actually better. Let's get a couple of them as well. There we go. Crixus's army will be ready in 10 turns, but we're not going to wait that full time. Treasury is empty. I don't give a damn. I am Spartacus. I don't care about that type of thing. So Rome, let us see if they will send their legions against us. If Rome's mighty legions will descend upon us like red, crimson blood rain upon the grey servile of the rebellion. I don't doubt it. Pussies. Pussies all. Alright, so we'll recruit those troops. Actually, you know what? It's always awkward for me to try and click on the actual unit I want to click on here. We hunger for battle. I mean, it's never like that with the other campaigns, it's just a few of the more recent ones and modifications that I'm having trouble with it. I don't understand why. Could be something on the coding level, I have no idea. Like the size of the selection box or something. Let's end this turn. You know what? I'm going to do a little phase here, a little fade to black, and then when you come back and when you join me once more, we will be ready to take Tarasina from the dirty Roman scum lords. Okay, so here we go. We're attacking a little Roman settlement here. Let's see what damage we can inflict. I mean, we do outnumber them greatly, but I really do want to show you the units and stuff. There's not much different than the design of the settlements or anything. It's just a faction change. But the design of the actual Servile units are pretty damn awesome, as well as the other factions, the other Servile revolts throughout the Roman Empire. There is a couple of peeves I have with it, just small pet peeves, but you know, they don't overall change my enjoyment of the game or the modification itself. It's just small things. Small irregularities with the armor and stuff. So here we go. They've always got a garrison fleet. Not that it's ever useful. I mean, as soon as you're in a battle, you just get them on land as quickly as possible. And it's always like a little skirmish unit. Never understood that. I mean, obviously, you have a garrison unit for land and for the sea. So we have no adverse effects. Let's begin our deployment. Right, let's get a good open field here. Spartacus ascends upon the Hold on. Yep, Spartacus appears before the annoying citizens of Rome, going about their daily activities, believing that they are safe, inflicting great harm and pain upon their slaves. Spartacus will soon rectify this problem. Look at those guys. Are they not brawny men? They are incredibly brawny men. Actually odd, because gladiators in real life would have been a lot heavier in weight, because, you know, getting sliced with a sword in your stomach or belly area, it's a lot better to have the fat cut than actual muscle. So they would have like a bit of a belly to deter any blades from actually cutting them deep. Right, get this here going here. Now Spartacus in the rear. Well, actually, you know, Spartacus is a freaking manly man. He'll get in the front. I always liked how his name was Spartacus, and yet he had nothing at all to do with Sparta. He was a Thracian, I think. Well, that's what I believe historians believe for themselves. Or maybe it actually is proven, I don't know. I mean, there's not that much evidence, I would suggest. I mean, there's very little known about his background, his origins. Other than he is a slave, and of course... That he's a slave and a gladiator. Turned general and leader. So let's get our little shepherds here. Put them in the front. There we go. It's always annoying setting up these formations at the start. There's never a decent formation set up. By default, you always have to do it yourself, which isn't actually a bad thing. I mean, I find it enjoyable. It's just it takes a lot of time out of the video itself. So there we go. Army set up. Get some cavalry on the left wing here. There's our little Roman army. What, Roman? Damn it. The complete opposite. Our servile army under the glorious Spartacus. Where is he? There he is there. There he is. Look at him. Burr pelt and everything. Guy is a complete badass. Let's begin this. The battle timer shows how much time. You know, I turned you off, mate. I don't know why you're still talking. Right, you know what? Let's send Spartacus in with his elites. What do you say, guys, huh? Let's see the servile veterans here. Right, they look like Romans. Well, they pretty much look like any... They grabbed any armor they could get, which is kind of realistic. They would have done that at the time. Similar to guerrilla warfare in this day and age. Like, they would hit and run, take whatever equipment they could after they've attacked. So, let's send in Spartacus. With his awesome gladiator units. Servile recruits. Speed this up. And of course, I'm not going to be showing you an entire campaign with like 50 parts. The fun part of a Total War game is that you can forge your own incredibly unique campaign. Make decisions that no other person would necessarily make. But I just like to show you the units, how it plays, what the influence is behind it. Right. Oh, Spartacus is in the middle of the formation here, the line formation. Awesome. Let's go, guys. Look at those freaking strong calf muscles. That's why Spartacus and his gladiators are victorious in every battle, because they've got calf muscles. The size of T-Rex calf muscles. Slow it down here. Where are we? It's different from the Attila version. Attila version's up the top, I think. Well, they're already routing. Dude's all covered in blood. Look at him. He's into this here. Look at him. Oh, he got butchered. Overrun. This battlefield will soon be crimson. Not only with blood, but with Roman shield. Got some heavy legionaries here. Where's Spartacus himself? Let's send Spartacus in, right? Let's send Spartacus in. Let's see what that's like. Stop everyone else. Spartacus, get into the fray, my man. The animation for a pilum is always awesome whenever they're throwing them in. Bring our cavalry around the rear here. What have they got? Well, that's their leader, is Decimus Lepidus. Let's see what presence does. I've never seen that before. Well, that's pretty awesome. War cry on the enemy units. I've also got a modification that enables every attack to be like an animation. So it's not just like a little jab or anything, which I suppose it is an animation, but it's like a kill animation. So the combat is a lot more cinematic and visceral. They're just waiting to get into the fight. Look at them, so impatient. Of course, a mix of every culture and race on Earth, apart from, well, where Rome didn't conquer, but slaves came from all over the empire to fight for Rome in the Colosseums and gladiatorial games. These assholes get on my freaking nerves. Damn plebs. You should be fighting for me, you plebs. Of course, the opportunity to become a citizen of Rome was too great for some slaves. Honor is not in their blood. Look at Spartacus, look at him go, look at him. Here he is here. Guy with the bear pelt over his shoulder. He is in the front lines unlike many other generals. Could name some Roman generals. Look at, oh damn! That guy just got decapitated. No, Spartacus, get up! Get up! You know what, guys? I don't even think I was Spartacus. There's a few guys with bear pelts over their shoulders. Oh, he is! It is him! He got up, look! Oh, he's having revenge! Oh, they got killed by somebody beside them. Where's my Kev? Bring a unit around the rear here. Get in there, my gladiators, to battle. Well, that's not what I'm doing. I want. Never mind. Never mind. Cinematic camera. Never mind. You're drunk. Go home. Soundtrack is awesome, by the way. I'll link that mod in the description below as well for you all to enjoy. I believe it works with the newest. Our latest version of the Emperor edition of Rome 2. Well, these infantry were pretty damn evenly matched, and I am sucking here because I really wanted more of a cinematic battle than just a Zerg swarm. Principes are awesome. One thing that the Servile units can't do is like a testudo. They're not trained in the actual formation of the Roman legionaries. They are trained in like gladiatorial combat, so it's more like one-on-one or small group combat, not like an actual battle line of hardened veterans with a shield wall and gladius from below to just pierce into their enemies' hearts. Where did that little... Oh shit, I think we're losing. Oh, they're chasing these guys. God damn it. Come on, dudes. You cowards. You will always be slaves. If not for the Roman Empire, then for another. Ah. Spartacus is fighting to the last man. Any other campaign faction would have routed by this point, but no. Spartacus stands strong. Like a true Thracian. Right, these guys are now on a killing spree and a headhunt. They pretty much went berserk at this point. Look at them go. Killing these shitty little town guard. Uruariai. Camera's being weird. Get into combat, you stop turning around looking at the camera. Must be camera shy. Oh, diamond! Our captain got killed there. No, Spartacus, no! Reinforcements? Well, they destroyed our general, but he's still alive, I wonder. Oh wow, Spartacus died this early in the campaign. Well, you see, if I was playing this realistically, that's what I want to tell you. I mean, this might not be true, but if I was playing this here for reals, I'd have killed all those enemy units and not even lost a single man. Wouldn't have broke a sweat. They might not think that's true, but that's up for you to decide. Right. It's funny how whenever they're writing, they don't care about anything other than their own lives. They do write in like a formation all of itself, which is weird. I like how in the other Total Wars they would just like spread out and stuff and just every man for himself pretty much. No friendly fire archers. Hold your fire. Scavenged Roman armor and the wolf pelts over the head is pretty damn awesome. I like the idea that this army is just grabbing whatever it can to fight. And even though some of these soldiers have never fought in their lives, these people, these slaves, they're still going to fight for their freedom, because freedom is the most expensive thing of all and the only thing worth holding. So there we go, guys. That is Spartacus Rises for Rome 2 Total War. You do require Hannibal at the gates. I will provide a link in the description below for all the modifications I have used in this modification. So go ahead and like, comment, subscribe. If you don't want to do either of those, See, English isn't my strong point. Well, it is, but it isn't. My brain doesn't work that fast. So thanks very much for watching overall, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.